Yes. What time is it? Oh,
that was my bed sheet.
I know. I borrowed my roommate's bed sheet for that last dirty sketch you saw. Do we have all Bear in Mind cast members backstage? Yes. More or less. Awesome. Guys, how'd you like that Far Side show? Pretty good for our last show of the semester. All our best sketches, debatably. Best in our opinion, you know, because we voted. That's how that last one got in there. You know, a corrupt system, truly. Kevin's here. Kevin's gonna host our show tonight. Our lovely director of Bear in Mind Improv. Clap it up for Kevin, guys. Oh my goodness, thank you so much everyone. We have some cast members filing in still, including one of our seniors is not even here yet. How great is that? Did he post on Facebook? What did he post?
My mom is sending us positive vibes, I think.
Well, his mom is here, but alright, we'll switch this up a little bit then. Cool, yeah, whatever, we'll figure it out. It's improv, guys, we're having a good time. Perfect, up first we have My Movie with Luke, Cameron, Matt, Tony, and someone who isn't Justin, who doesn't want to play a game later.
Cool. I'll do it first.
Is that Dan
Miller? Yeah, guys, like Noah said, this is our best of our favorite games we've played through the year. This is my final semester, it's my final show as a Bear in Mind director. I should have said that, that's a big deal. Also sending off Bryn Habel and Justin Steckman whenever he decides to be here. Classic. Perfect, but why not? We'll get it started. So the way this is going to work is that we're going to get a word from you, the audience. Is he here?
He's here!
He made it! He made it! Oh my goodness. We weren't going to start without you, buddy. Alright, hey Justin. Hey, good friend. Alright, we don't need to wait till the end of the show, my goodness. Alright, so how this is gonna work is that we're gonna get a word from you, the lovely audience. They're gonna be getting titles for movies that don't exist based off of that word. So first of all, I guess I just need so if I like the movie title, I'm gonna ask for a genre of it. They'll give me a genre. If I like the genre, I'm gonna ask for a tagline. So like aliens, it's a sci-fi. In space, no one can hear you scream. If we like that tagline, I'm gonna point to you, the audience, and we're all gonna get involved and say, let's see that. Can I try that one time?
Let's see that!
Perfect, wonderful, yeah, they wanna see it. Cool, so I just need a word. What's your favorite word?
Tortilla!
Yes! Quesadilla? Biopic. It's about J Dilla, the rapper.
Let's see that!
Wow, I'm J Dilla.
Oh, dude, biggest fan. Oh my god.
I'm gonna die to Tom Shirley. Yep. You're gonna love this.
Oh my god.
It says J Dilla.
Hard press. It's a Marlon Wayans movie. You guys get it?
Tortilla, yes. Horror.
Oh,
everyone's gonna die in this movie.
Let's see that!
Derek, I'm scared.
Oh, it's okay, we're probably not gonna die.
Okay.
Have you guys seen a killer around here?
No,
we
haven't.
I just checked over there. No killers in the back.
Oh, cool.
I think we're totally safe.
I'm still a little scared, guys.
Hey, it's me. I'm the guy that said I wasn't a killer. Hey, guys, how y'all doing tonight?
So far, so good.
Why do you have so much blood on your shirt?
I'm a butcher. So, I just got off the job.
Yeah.
You guys want to come check out my shop?
Yes!
Come on!
Little flippers.
kids movie. It didn't stop at Wales.
Let's see that!
I'm gonna be just like a killer whale, Mom. And just like you.
I'm really proud of you, son. Can you put me back in my tank, please?
Yes.
Masa, masa. It's a Shanti workout video.
Come on, come on, come on! I really don't think I can keep up, Shanti.
I'm sorry. I haven't been able to keep up this entire time either.
I mean, yeah, it seems like you kind of threw in the towel with this one. You're not even trying. I mean, Insanity was great. Brazilian bun workout was awesome.
Oh, it's been downhill
masa,
since...
Masa, masa,
it's been downhill since masa, masa, man. My wife left. My kid graduated. He's at a great school, but it's out of state.
That's bitch.
And they messed up my vasectomy.
That was my movie. That was great. Check those out. We'll be in theater soon. Hopefully. Oh boy, up next we get to play Human Props. My favorite game to play with myself and Justin. Get on up here, Justin. And since this night is all about moving on, I'm also going to ask up Assistant Director Noah Hunt to introduce this game. Give it up for your future Paramount Director. Give it up. I would stay here if I could, though, to be honest.
All right, so this game is called Human Props, and for this game, I'm going to need two audience volunteers. So I'm eager. We got one. We need two. Yes, you right there.
Yeah!
Do it. Do it.
Yes!
Oh, yes, me.
All right, I trust these guys' instincts. Why don't you guys introduce yourselves to the audience?
Hi, my name is Neville.
Chris.
All right, we got Neville. So, Kevin and Justin, our improvisers, are going to be human props in this game, meaning they can't control their own bodies. These guys, our lovely audience volunteers, are going to be moving their bodies for them. So give it a try. Just practice. Move your dummy.
Oh, I move your... This is so much more work than I thought.
Just like that. If you want them to move, you can tap their legs. You can do whatever. Be as gentle as you want. So, for this game, can I get a suggestion of a location?
Church.
Church. This scene is going to take place in church. Clap it up for Human Props.
Good, my child. It is good that you have come to learn how to be a priest. The most fabulous priest in the world. For I, Father Santiago, I love the Lord. Oh, I feel it coming through. Now, Brother Johnson, I will look above you because that is where the Lord is. Now look into my eyes. Are you ready to sacrifice your life to the Lord?
I indeed I am.
Okay, don't give yourself whiplash there. That would be good.
I'm just very excited.
Okay, why don't you stand so we can work on our prayers? Hang on. I'm reading your mind. Get out of my head! This is part of the
Get
process.
Get out of my nose!
This is part of the process. Okay, you are very holy. Don't you dare read my eyes. Don't you dare!
More to teach me.
I do.
Look at me.
Pardon me, my back's a little bit sore. Stress that out, okay. Now, every good priest must know how to recite Bible verses with, ooh, that feels very nice, Brother Johnson. Oh, the spirit's come through me. Thou shalt not massage train in church. Brother Johnson.
I did a bad thing.
You're sitting. Yeah, Neville!
Oh boy, immediately glad that did not go to kissing.
yeah, right?
We're going to keep it moving with a game called Kill Word with Tony, Brent, Cody, and Matt. Get on up here. That's right, the way this is going to work is that three of these improvisers are going to be given a word. If that word is said by the fourth improviser, who will be outside when we get the words, that fourth improviser says the word, whoever word that is has to die immediately, and it has to be justified as to why they just died. There's also going to be a win word, and if that win word is said, the game immediately ends. It's happened before right off the bat, so we'll see how that goes. So first of all, I need a number 1 through 4.
4.
4, so Matt will be going out into the airlock. He will be trying to get those words, killing off his friends, in improv, of course. Okay, as soon as he's out in the airlock. Okay, perfect. How about let's first get a location for the scene to take place.
Library.
Finals. Right? Huh. Anyway, what's a word that you associate with a library? When you go to a library, what?
Sleeping.
Okay, Brent, your word's gonna be sleep.
Sleep.
For Cody, let's get something that maybe you would look up in the library.
NASCAR.
Some fun.
Yeah, that makes sense.
There's no way he's. Yeah, we'll do NASCAR. Why not? We'll see. We'll see what happens. And for Tony, what is the word that you just need to check the dictionary every time?
Bumblebee.
You bumblebee? Okay. Yeah, why, sure. Bumblebee. Bumblebee. Wow. This is going to be hard on Matt to kill you guys off. And then what is the win? What is something that would, like, besides Bumblebee and NASCAR, you would never say in the library?
Moist.
Like moist. Moist. I know people hate it, but I like saying it over the mic. Moist. Moist. Cool. The win word is moist, so if he says it, you'll win. Let's get Matt back in here. Remember, if he says your word, you die. Clap it up for Kill Word, everyone. Give it up.
Hey, guys.
Hey. Hey, John.
Thank you for coming to my Bible study.
What a place to do
it. By the way, Matt, your the location is a library. I forgot to tell you that.
You're welcome.
This is my favorite religious library.
Sam, we came straight to the Vatican to come here. So
yeah, we're integrating this new Bible study program in the Vatican Library.
That's great. Thanks, John.
It is so bright in this library. My eyes are having a hard time adjusting to it.
Oh, bring your glasses down a little bit. That helps.
Oh.
Did anyone else get jet lag? Yes.
Yeah, I've been really feeling tired since I got off the flight.
Yeah, pretty long flight.
I've been up for like 48 hours, man.
Wow, that's not good.
That's
for you.
Really unhealthy.
I read that's pretty bad for your health, actually. A book I found here.
You know what else is bad for your health? When you're outside and those little bugs are like flying around that sting you. You know, I forget what those are called.
Oh, bees.
Damp.
Moist.
Yeah.
Yeah! That
was a good word! He did it! He saved the life, everyone! Cody and Tony are actually dead. They don't get to come back. No, they do! They do! It's a joke, guys! It's a comedy show! Laughing! I'm just kidding, that's cheesy as hell. Anyway, we're gonna play Superheroes with Cody, and it's Justin, Kevin, and Laylee. Get on up here. Get on up. Get on up. And I'm gonna need Noah Hunt back up on stage. Give it up for Noah again, everyone.
This game we're going to play is called Superheroes. As you can guess, it involves superheroes and supervillains. So we're going to start off with one singular hero alone on stage, and then we're going to see a couple of different short scenes that bring more heroes and villains into the picture, and it's all going to climax in one final battle. So first from you guys, I want you guys to choose which improviser would you like to start off as our singular hero?
Evan!
I heard Evan. So Evan's going to start off. Everyone else is going to lead. Guys, what is Evan's superhero name?
Christmas guy. Christmas guy.
I think I'm gonna roll with Christmas guy. It's just big enough to have so much potential. So Christmas guy, and also for you guys, I need a suggestion of a crisis. What is the problem he needs to solve?
Chipotle's got like so much E. coli.
Chipotle has got so much E. coli. Like so much. All right, clap it up for superheroes, guys.
Tim Allen, no one's gonna believe you. We'll figure it out eventually, guy. Is that the slight rustling of sleigh bells, which are actually my warning system? Computer device!
Hi.
What's going on? It sounds like there's a crisis.
Yeah, it's E. coli.
Oh my god. Christmas is in 7 months. If this E. coli outbreak happens by the time it's Christmas Eve, then... well, it's gonna be a sad Christmas for Santa.
Computer update, there is so much E. coli.
It's even worse! Super Paul! I was waiting for the call. I slept in your bushes. Thanks so much, every soap opera character.
I slept there because Maria left me. Maria! Ay, Dios! Dios! Ay, Dios!
She lying, guys.
That's ay, Dios mio.
Look! There's so much E. coli! And so many twins I never knew about!
Hey, I know it's a problem! That's why I called you to help! I can't do it on my own here, I got candy canes to sharpen! I got cookies to make!
Only one person could be involved with this!
You don't mean...
That's right! The cowboy who never knows when the shootout is over, kid!
Actually, your twin.
I wish my dad was here.
Ding dong. Hi.
Oh no! Just come right in. I didn't even open the door for you.
I know who this is.
Hi.
Your cowboy who never knows when the shootout is over. Kid's dad.
Yeah. Joe, nice to meet you. I'm really concerned about my kids, so.
Oh, you joined the side of good.
I wouldn't call it good, just kind of like a weekend...
By the way,
hobby.
The surgery wasn't successful. I'm still a man.
Hey, good for you, man.
Hey, man, it's a gift that you're here.
Yeah.
Because you're the one who knows the weakness about your son.
Yeah, I do know the weakness about my son, but I really hope he isn't with, you know, Cowgirl, who doesn't know how to lasso anything.
Is that an equally useless team?
They got a team going there.
Well, yeah, I mean, twins and stuff.
Ah, I know that game!
You're gonna kill yourself? We have a suicide pact, man!
It's gonna be over.
Okay, well, now it's even. We both have guns in our hands.
I thought you were gonna do
this. The last. The last! The last!
That's like a fake assumption.
Man, that was a pretty voice for me. Sorry. That was a really negative person that just came out. But it's fine. As long as you don't say the L word, it's fine.
Lasso?
I'd lasso. I'd throw it up, but I can't lasso.
I think we should just go sneeze on more tomatoes at Chipotle. Yeah. It's like, there's so much E. coli.
I'll take a burrito with...
You think it's so easy, don't you? When you have two arms!
Maybe it's like a salad.
Salad.
Wait a second! That's the crisis we're trying to stop!
Hey, don't order that burrito or bowl!
Wait, it must be cowgirl and cowboy. They must be shooting bullets and sneezing all over the food.
What you?
Oh, they're not! Yeah. They're at this Chipotle that we called. Oh, gosh!
Okay, I'm not gonna lie, guys. I was gonna save these for you for Christmas, but I brought you nuclear weapons.
Whoa!
I thought you'd like that!
Oh.
Huh.
Oh.
What the hell are you doing here, Dad?
What the hell are you doing here, guys?
Wait a second! I know that face!
And the cowboy kid who doesn't
I know what you are!
The cowboy kid who doesn't know when the shootout's up.
What happened to your arm?
Son!
No, my dad's.
No! We're both your father. You were adopted.
Yes.
And then sent to Pennsylvania.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
We are lost with you, young man. Sneezing all over these tomatoes. We raised you better.
Also, I never really lost my arm.
Ooh, that's a twist.
Son, come back to the good side. You don't need to sneeze on these tomatoes. We can live together and be happy, and no one will die in a helicopter crash. I promise. It only happened once.
Yeah, and you can come along.
You can come along too. Like I'm some like side dish.
Wait. I know who this is.
She's the girl who doesn't know how to lasso.
Ow! Sorry,
guys. That was great.
Mother, I've been looking for you for so long.
I know. What the?
My uterus aches of a memory. I am your mother.
What's happening? If you're my daddy, you're my daddy.
I'm definitely
daddy. You're my.
I'm actually Jewish.
Oh, that was amazing. Look at that on HBO. This coming summer. Wonderful. We're going to keep moving with a game called Weekend at Bernie's with Matt, Brynn, and Cameron. Get on up here. Get on up. Pretty new game that we're playing. The way this is going to work is that these three are going to do a short scene. And when the scene is over, I'll cut it. And we will see that same scene again. The only difference is that one of these improvisers will die before the second scene begins. The other two will have to pull their body around and make them reenact the scene. Kind of like Weekend at Bernie's when they take him through. And it's a movie. Check it out. Spoiler. Yeah, sorry.
But that will eventually lead to the third scene, in which another cast member will die, and it will be one person running frantically trying to control two bodies and recreate the scene. So first of all, let's get a workplace for these three.
White House.
You guys are at the White House. When you're ready, clap it up for Weekend at Bernie's.
Hey, Mr. President, here's the tacos you ordered.
Oh, thank you.
I got the two kinds of hot sauce, because sometimes you say you want mild, but then you're like, this isn't hot enough for me, so I just...
Mr. President, I just wondered if you could possibly sign these documents. I've been signing your signature all day, and my hand is just, like, cramping up. So.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Thank you.
Do I need to be here for this, or...?
Yeah, stay.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks for asking. Thanks for bothering to ask, you know.
Why didn't you get a taco?
Hey, did the Russians ever agree to bomb China?
Let's hold on to that.
Well, that's part of the agreement that you're signing there. You know, they just want to make sure that you were going to send them what you told them that you'd send them. Of course, all the...
Did you forget to sign a paper about getting a taco, or you don't like them? They're good. Did you eat lunch?
Mr. President, can we talk about this maybe in turn?
Yeah, can we talk about the tacos?
Okay. Well, I miss, what the hell is with this taco shit? As head of Secret Service, I expect you to talk about more than just tacos.
I mean, I feel like we have a country to run here. The president is working very hard to run the country.
Yeah,
and you're talking about tacos.
You know what, Linus? You try signing papers.
Yeah.
Take a seat. You try signing papers.
It's not as easy as it looks.
Like, it's always just like Russia this and like Afghanistan. It's just like, let's talk about tacos for a second.
And see. Perfect. That was pretty good. But now we're going to make it a little bit more challenging. Who would you like to die in the second scene?
Cameron!
Ken will be dead, so whenever you're ready, just go ahead. There you go, nice and slow. Now let's see that same scene again. Whenever you're ready, clap it up for the second scene.
Oh, Mr. President, I brought these tacos for you. There you go.
Yeah. Right, thank you.
Do you like hot sauce or like whatever? And then tacos? Tacos and stuff? Did I say tacos already? Tacos.
Mr. President, I'm going to need you to sign these papers. I've been signing your name all day, and I just wondering if you could please sign this.
Absolutely.
Paper.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Great. Do you not get the message about the tacos? Because I was talking about tacos. I checked in just now. I didn't say anything.
Did Russia ever agree to bomb China?
Yeah, that's what actually you're signing the papers.
Okay.
Did I say anything about tacos? Tacos and shit!
Alright, Linus! You know what? As head of Secret Service, I'm sick of taco shit being your only job.
Well, I just. Tacos, you know?
You know what, Linus? Take a seat and try and sign some papers.
Okay. I'll do that right now. I'm just gonna talk.
Take a seat, Linus.
This year. And do the job,
because
you can't do it, and I like tacos.
Let's see. That was pretty good. You guys did a pretty good job. We need another death, though.
Matt
is dead.
Matthew.
So Matt, whenever ready, go ahead and just take it slow. Good job, Cameron. You know the drill. Perfect. So let's see that third C. Clap it up.
Mr. President, here's tacos here. Here's some tacos for you, Mr. President. I'm just gonna sit next to you.
Mr. President, I'm gonna need you to sign this.
Whoa, Mr. President. tacos. Mr. President, did I ask you about your tacos yet? You ordered some tacos, and I was wondering what kind of hot sauce you wanted on your tacos. I like the hot sauce from Taco Bell. Yes! Did we talk to the Russians about China? Did we talk to them about China yet? Do they have tacos? I don't know if they have
That game was Bryn hates Matt and Cameron. Do you want tacos? Oh, I'm fresh. Both their voices. We're going to keep moving with a game called Forwardverse with Noah, Laylee, and Evan. Keep it moving right along. Get on up here. Give them a round of applause. We're having a fun time, guys. Moving past last show of the semester. It's hit me. Anyway, we're going to keep it moving. Keep it fun. Keep it fresh. We're going to play a game where these three are going to be doing a scene at any time. Off stage, I can yell reverse. They will have to redo the action they just did. I can call forward. They go back into normal speed. That's pretty much the game, and I can mess around with them, have them go forward and back a couple times. So first of all, let's get a non-geographical location?
Underwater,
why not? Underwater is just a clap it up for forwarders.
Sammy Sea Lion. So nice to mermaids like me.
And I got a good sense of humor. What did the mustache say to the lips? I don't know, I'm only 12. Yes.
Worse. Table over there. Hey, table sitters, raise your hand. Okay, this is. I didn't even mean those table sitters. No. Yes, and that's the first rule of improv. Now you all learn something. The way this is gonna work is that us four are gonna be doing a scene. We're all gonna have suggestions for each other. However,
Whoa, it's the last show, folks.
Yikes.
Oh,
we
stepped
on the floor.
Oh. Yeah. Anyway, the way this is gonna work is that two improvisers will be under the water. Oh boy.
Check. Oh, look at that. Anyway, two improvisers. Why is it all like froggy?
It's high. You put the water in.
Oh, God. I spit in it. So anyway, us four, we're gonna be in, two people are gonna be in the water with their heads underneath so they can't hear or see what's going on. The other two will be performing a scene. Once they start running out of air, they'll raise their hand, we'll have to tag out and start whatever scene we were at. Let's just quickly go around and get suggestions. We need one for everyone, huh? Okay, ship, well, it's not gonna ship up though. Oh, just one big scene. All right, no, it'll just be one big scene then. So let's get, it won't really matter, but let's get a workplace, or let's get a relationship.
Stepdads
is a suggestion. Bryn and Justin, whenever you guys are ready, you can start it. Clap it up for water torture.
Nice.
Yeah. Dad, I don't want you to move away.
I'm sorry, son. You know, I just hate your mom, and I want to bang the girl next door.
She can change, Dad. She can change.
She can't change how old she is.
Bryn.
I'll go grab her.
Fuck the girl next door.
Man, this is some bullshit.
I'm dead ass
honest with you right now.
I've been trying to fix that sprinkler for like 8.5 years. Like, not even kidding.
Who are you?
Man, I'm a gardener. I've been trying to...
Dad, I learned something! The gardener was just in here!
I learned the girl next door likes anal.
What?! The gardener's fucking mom!
Good, because I'm not.
Oh, God! You have
to some happiness. I'm gonna go apologize to her.
Me too! Jesus!
I think we need to reconsider this gardening thing.
I really think we're awful at this gardening thing.
I mean, this is a bad neighborhood. There's promiscuous sex,
there's
families.
The shower is broken, Dad! The shower is broken!
I didn't get a chance to apologize to your mom. I barely see her, you know, but I'm used to it.
Also, I probably should have taken out my phone before showering! Hey, listen here, you stupid gardener!
Brent!
Don't get my mom! Wait, no, don't get my mom! Oh, hey!
No!
Are you my wife? I barely see you.
Hey, let's run away together. I'm tired of this bullshit laying around.
All the
fucking pipes are broken.
Might as well be Atlantis.
Go check my dad and see if he's upstairs. Daddy! Dad, the pipes are still broken. I'm gonna go try to fix them.
I'm gonna try, but I'm not a good dad, so I can't fix them.
So you still want me to keep working on your sprinkler?
Yeah, that'd be great. I'm gonna go fuck the girl next door again.
Wait, no.
Remove this.
Yeah.
Oh man, I wish I had brought another shirt. Do not spill it. No, do not spill it. Oh my god.
Guys, there's only just like cords and wires.
Just put it off stage. I'll deal with it. I'm smarter than all three of you. I've had a lot of.
I dare you to butt chug it. Yeah.
That's at the after party. Yeah. That's disgusting. Cool. As much as I want to keep dripping on this mic, we're going to be doing some long form. The way this is going to work is that someone's going to be. Oh, God. Someone is going to be telling a monologue. We're going to do some scenes off that monologue, and then we'll end it and do some awards for both Farside and Bear in Mind. So this is long form. I'm going to give the monologue, if that's cool with everyone, my last monologue as a cast member. Director of this awesome crew. Sure. If it cuts out or if I get electrocuted, just remember, I loved ASU comedy so much. Cool.
Kevin.
Yeah, I just need a word.
Inconspicuous.
Okay, yeah. Inconspicuous, when I think of inconspicuous, I think of like trying not to stick out. Is that that's like inconspicuous? Is you're trying to like blend in? I have the most opposite story about that. It happened when I was in the first grade. No, third grade. Excuse me. So anyway, in third grade, I went to school in California. It was at my elementary school, and one of my favorite things to do at recess was to ride the swings. And for some reason back then, like, swing tricks were like a big thing. Like, it was like a competition. Everyone would run out and be like, I got the new, like, Tarzan chain whip! And you, like, fly off the side and, like, hopefully not break your arm. Or kick someone in the face. But anyway, I had been working on this awesome trick after school, which I like to call the egg. Which I would hang down under the swing, like upside down. Now in my head, I was like, that's gonna be great. Yeah. However, I had not tried the egg, and my upper body hanging down was not short enough not to take in the sand. Yeah, we're getting ahead of ourselves, but anyway, that's not the worst part. So anyway, I'm like, I got this trick, guys. And I run out there, I get on, and I start pumping my legs, I'm getting up, and I was like, all right, here we go, make it or break it. All of a sudden, these three girls who, like, in elementary school, was like, I'm gonna be cool for the girls. Walked by, and I went to lean back, and instead of doing this great trick that worked in my head, my pants just kind of slipped off, so I went even lower and just was looking at sand coming out of my face, and just was like, this is how I die, and I just smashed my face, like, I get up, and my pants are down, and these girls are, like, laughing at me. Yeah, no, not my underwear, luckily, I had my underwear on. But it wouldn't have mattered anyway, because I was in the third grade, so... Like, oh, that kid's pinky's out! But anyway, I pulled up my pants, ran up into the jungle gym, and just, like, sobbed my eyes out with, like, sand in my eyes. I recovered somewhat. I have a girlfriend now, which I guess is full recovery, guys! So let's see some scenes on My Sad Life.
Jim, come out of the bathroom, man! You pooped your pants giving a speech 10 years ago! We're in high school now!
Yeah, I'm not gonna do it, I'm gonna kill
you. What did you even eat in there?
Toilet paper? There's a lot of fiber in it.
Come on, man! No. We said we'd be best friends for life!
Yeah, we still
be I have a hot friends. Date to the prom! Yeah, I need you to have my back, dude!
Yeah, I'll have you back from behind this door. I can still be your friend.
Just do we have to take the door with us to prom?
I mean...
That's a prom.
What's happening?
Hey, I'm totally getting in tonight.
Hey, I appreciate you calling me a hot date and all, but is your friend ever gonna step out from behind that door?
Did you tell her that I shit my pants on
It's been 10 years since he shit his pants.
You told her? You didn't say anything.
Wait.
Pause, prom.
Oh my god, I love Pitbull!
Darling. Hey, listen, back there behind the door, it's okay, nothing will happen, it's just prom, it's the best time of your life!
See, but what if I get elected prom king
and give a speech? That's right, I'm a woman! Actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
Yeah? That sounds dramatic.
Dude, you don't need to narrate everything, I'm right here.
I didn't want to let you know. That at least?
But I shit my pants on the limo ride over here.
Did you hear that?
You are so gorgeous!
I don't know who to believe. He's my best friend.
Okay, Janice, look, I learned this new jump rope trick, and I wanted to show it to you. I call it the one foot, and then the other foot, jump. Oh. Fucking Christ.
Man, swim practice was so brutal.
Yeah, but do you see those chicks in the front row, man? They totally saw me do my backstroke.
I know.
So, the other day I was, like, walking with my dog, and I was really cool.
Oh, hey, ladies. Don't mind me. It's just my speedo. Yeah, dude, they totally saw my donger poking right out of the way.
Backstroke? Oh, the stroke I made up on the spot.
Dude, that was
Tarzan chain whip.
Oh, that's great one.
I just thought, there's no way.
I really think that we have a chance with these girls. Like, they were so into us, especially when I hit that special trick.
Oh, yeah.
The Michael right. Phelps.
Yeah.
It was great.
Too soon? Too soon?
works here now.
The test results came back. You're gonna make a full recovery, kind of. It's gonna be absolutely fine.
Dr. Matthews, I appreciate your
I'm just being candid.
But I just want to know what's
absolutely okay.
But what does this mean? Am I going to recover or not?
You are gonna make a complete recovery. That's it. You're gonna make a recovery.
Doctor, you were operating for 12 hours just telling me is my spleen removed or not?
Oh, I got the spleen, but you're probably never gonna get a girlfriend.
Okay, just tell me how much time does the bomb have until it explodes, okay?
The time it isn't enough.
I got it.
You have to tell us the bomb squad.
Just tell them, like, it's gonna, it'll be eventually.
Eventually it's gonna be.
Are you coming or no?
I'm going out there.
Yeah.
I'm going out there, Tom. And I'm going to put on the best swing exposition this school has ever seen.
You better. You put together this whole thing.
You got my pyrotechnics, right?
Yeah, I get the pyrotechnics. I get the backup dancers.
Pray with me.
I really
pray with me!
Whatever,
oh, shoot. Oh, gosh. It's Big Swing Ricky. Hey, Big Swing Ricky. Can you see my routine out there? You'll know it's real.
We're all doing the routine together. It's not...
Wait, he's on our team? I thought you brought him in to train against him.
You want to get better. You team up with Nemesis.
All right, Big Swing Ricky, we're going out there. We'll do this together.
Together.
All right, we better get out there. Just remember, those pyrotechnics...
Yeah, I got it.
All right.
Try not to slow me down.
It's me, the pirate. I've got...
Stage. All right, third through fourth graders, gather around. It's lunchtime, and we're making you watch this kid swing.
Hey, you might want to step back, pirate.
Oh, you said pirate tactics, got
it. I was a
pirate. I got
it. Tom, what are you doing? Hurry!
We are swinging too long. We go all the way over the pole if we don't jump soon!
I thought that was a myth!
It is no myth!
Pyrotechnics, but it didn't bring the detonator.
You better hurry! We're gonna go over the top!
I'm gonna go get a detonator. I'll be right back.
We need no detonator! This is for Russia!
Big Swing Ricky! Big Swing Ricky, no! He's got a suicide vest! Get away!